The other thing you can do is to export the historical data from your broker. How you can do that? Go to File and go to User Files folder, and here you have the script. Now what I will do, I will copy it, I will go to File, Open Data folder on MetaTrader, I will hit on MQL4 and I will go to Scripts. Here I will paste that script, and again I will go to Scripts and right click and refresh. So I'll compile this script, very same thing as we do with the expert advisors. And now before I use the script to export that data, what I will do, I will zoom out as maximum as I can and I will press the home key on my keyboard to load bars. Make sure you uncheck that, scroll the chart to the end on tick incoming bottom, so it will not keep you always at the current candlestick, and press home key and just hold it. This way you are loading the bars from the beginning. In this case, my broker offers data from the 29th of September 2017 on hourly chart. Okay, I will do that for all time frames. Just press home key and hold it. For M30, let's see how far I will go back in time. 2018 January. On M15 I will do the same, and I will simply do that for all time frames. Just go through them and press the home key and hold it. I will be using this script to export the data from my broker, and in this way I'll be 100% sure that I'll be using the same data from the server where I'll be trading. Okay, and if you are trading live on a live account, you should do the same, because the brokers have different servers for demo and for live trading. Okay, so I went quickly through all of the time frames, and now I will drag and drop the script, and you can see here I have the maximum count of bars. Let's change to 200,000, which I believe is enough. Commission is zero, as we checked with that broker, and I can enter spread. If I leave it to zero, it will be the current spread. Okay, but as I said, 20 works better for me, and I will hit on OK, and this will export all of the bars. We have the one-click trading, but we have a limitation from MetaTrader to 65,000 bars. How you can remove that, or how you can increase it, go to Tools and hit on Options, then go to Charts, and instead of 65,000, just press 9 as much as you can. And same thing on the left side, hit on OK, and then double click on the data export one more time, 200,000 bars, and hit on OK. And you can see that I exported just 2 bars more for the 1 minute time frame. But actually, this is how much the broker offers as a maximum at the current moment. Now, if this data is not enough for you, what you can do is just leave your MetaTrader open when you're trading with the EIS, or when you're trading manually, doesn't matter, just keep it open and it will collect the bars with the time. It will add the new bars to the existing historical data. So if you use the script to export data later on, you will have more bars. Now, where you can find that data, go to File, Open Data folder, and then hit on MQL4 and go to Files. And here is the data. Now what you can do, simply open the FSB Pro and you can drag and drop that data over the program just like that, and you will see that you downloaded the bars from your broker. So if we compare the data from the FSB Pro, we can see that we have way more bars, like 200,000 for the M1 and M5 and M15 time frames, and we have just 65,000 from the broker that I selected to use. And now if I hit on new strategy, I can select to use the FSB demo data or the xm.com/demo data, or this is the data that I have just exported from the MetaTrader platform.